news coming in right now. A month after suspected ISIS terrorist Saifullah was killed in a police encounter in Lucknow, the UP anti-terror squad has busted yet another module with the suspected ISIS links, arresting three suspects. The arrests were made after the UP ATS or the anti-terror squad conducted raids in a joint operation with the special cell of Delhi police, Maharashtra ATS, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar and Punjab police. The ISIS suspects were arrested from Mumbai, from Jalandhar, from Bijnor, and six others are now being questioned. These suspects were picked up following intelligence inputs suggesting that a group was being formed to launch operations, and some active members were in the process of recruiting newer members. This is what we are picking up right now, and these are the details that we have right now. Six others are being questioned right now. Three have been arrested for suspected ISIS links, and raids have been conducted in various places across the country, in various cities across the country. We'll be giving you the lowdown and the details in just a second. In fact, my colleague Saurabh Sanyal joins us with more on this. Saurabh, these are raids conducted at multiple places. Walk us through where all the raids were conducted.
Well, that's right, Uttar. In fact, this is possibly the biggest terror crackdown, because remember, this is very, very significant because the raids have come at a time in just about a month after these suspected IS operative, we all remember, who was gunned down by the UP ATS in Lucknow. Remember that he was holed up in a house. Let's just quickly take you through, Uttar and the viewers, what really happened and how this crackdown could be, took shape, because there was intelligence input, specific intelligence inputs, which prompted this entire coordinated team effort, effort which was spearheaded by the UP ATS. Now, which were the other agencies that were involved? We know that the UP ATS essentially took the lead in terms of the terror crackdown. They are the ones who essentially got all the other states on board and told them whatever inputs were there. Since the UP ATS then, you know, going by the intelligence inputs that they had, they got in touch first with the Punjab police. Then Delhi police was also roped in over here. Now, you see towards the western part of the country, Maharashtra ATS too was brought in as a key player in this entire combing operation. Then towards the east, Bihar police was also brought in, as well as down south, the Andhra Pradesh police also joined hands. So this was essentially a big and a planned and a coordinated campaign that was mounted essentially by all these investigating agencies. Now let's quickly take you through as to what are the different cities which are under the scanner. When we say cities under the scanner, which means that the investigating agencies are laying special attention on these particular cities, since there are specific inputs which suggest that IS modules could actually be operating, or there could be sleeper cells of the IS in these cities. What are these cities? You see that, you know, that the places are Jalandhar, Bijnor, in Bihar, and Muzaffarnagar and Mumbai. So these are the cities essentially where the raids were conducted by these agencies, by the different state agencies, so to say, who got into action mode. And here in Punjab, the Punjab police, where the raids were conducted by these agencies, by the different state agencies, so to say, who got into action mode. And here in Punjab, the Punjab police got down, and Jalandhar is the city where they zeroed in on. Similarly, Bijnor over here and Muzaffarnagar in UP, so big focal points really for the investigating agencies. And here you see that in Bihar, again, a very, very crucial link to this entire matrix as how it has evolved. And we see then, you know, that operatives also were found from Mumbai, and that is where the focus really was, you know, also a lot of attention went towards Mumbai. Quickly, let me just now take you through as to what really are the other aspects in this entire matrix. Now, as we have already told you, that this was a coordinated terror crackdown, and the suspects essentially, three suspects have been arrested, one from Jalandhar, one from Bijnor, and one from Mumbai. So raids were conducted at multiple locations across the country based on specific inputs, since there were inputs which suggested that these sleeper cells could be active, that there was a grouping which was happening where recruits were being, you know, approached, possible recruits were being approached, and these key people who have been arrested now, who are being interrogated, have been picked up from Jalandhar, from Bijnor and from Mumbai. One was on his way to the mosque when he was picked up, and clearly, so this shows the entire nexus and how these operatives have been picked up from these three cities, how essentially they were planning to go ahead and carry forward the ISIS ideology, to penetrate that in Indian soil and to try and get in more recruits into their fold. Uttar?
Stay with us, Saurabh. We're also getting reactions now. Daljit Singh, the ADG of Uttar Pradesh, has also given a reaction on these raids. Let's take a look at what he's saying.
या किसी बाहर के किसी भी एजेंसी के साथ उनका लायसन नहीं है परंतु ये सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड सेल्फ गाइडेड सेल्फ रेडिकलाइज्ड अपने आप को खुद ही किन्हीं माध्यम से उन्होंने अपने आप को प्रेरित किया है और वो इस प्रकार से कोई ग्रुप बनाया है उन्होंने जिसके कार जो मिलकर एक घटना करना चाहते थे उसी को लेकर ये ऑपरेशन किया गया और इन लोगों की गिरफ्तारी हुई है
किस तरह का क्या करना चाह रहे थे और ग्रुप कितना बड़ा था क्या क्या तैयारी थी उनके पास
जैसे कि सर्वेलेंस में पाया कि ये लगातार आपस में विचार विमर्श कर रहे थे किसी एक घटना को कारित करने के लिए और उसकी तैयारी में ये लोग लगे थे सभी के यहां से सर्च हुआ है यद्यपि ऐसा कोई भी इंक्रिमिनेटिंग एविडेंस ऐसा बॉम्ब या कोई ऐसी चीज नहीं बरामद हुई है परंतु जो उनके तैयारियां थी जिस हिसाब से वो बातचीत और तैयारी कर रहे थे उस हिसाब से उनके खिलाफ जो उनकी कार्रवाइयां थी वो एक आपराधिक षड्यंत्र माना जा सकता है उसी को लेकर इसमें अग्रिम कार्रवाई की गई है और हमारा मुख्य उद्देश्य ये रहेगा कि हमारा ये मानना है कि ये मिसगाइडेड यूथ हैं ये अपने पथ से भ्रमित हुए हैं उन सबको वापस काउंसलिंग करके इनको वापस मेन स्ट्रीम में दाखिल किया जाए जैसे मैंने बताया ये एक षड्यंत्र बना रहे थे यद्यपि उसमें ये लोग सफल नहीं हुए क्योंकि हमने उनको पहले ही एक प्रिवेंटिव कार्रवाई के तहत हमने उनको अपनी हिरासत में ले लिया
सर यूपी से कितने गिरफ्तार किए गए
इसका खुलासा भी हम बहुत जल्दी एक प्रेस नोट के माध्यम से करने वाले अभी तक की जो जानकारी है ये एक ऐसा कार्य करना चाह रहे थे जिससे कि निश्चित रूप से क्षेत्र में आतंक फैले
कोई आतंकी किसी ग्रुप से आईएसआईएस वगैरह से जुड़े हैं सर कोई आतंकी घटना को अंजाम देने वाले थे या कोई आपराधिक ऐसी घटना को अंजाम देने वाले थे
जैसे मैंने बताया कि एक आपराधिक घटना करने के षड्यंत्र में ये लोग सब शामिल थे पुलिस की और अन्य एजेंसीज की जो कि अन्य मतलब अन्य स्टेट्स की भी एजेंसीज हमारे साथ इसमें इन्वॉल्व थी उनके साथ मिलकर इसको पहले ही इस पूरे ग्रुप को अरेस्ट कर लिया गया
लखनऊ में अभी एक मारा गया था उससे कोई लिंक मिल रहा
है लखनऊ वाले इंसिडेंट से इसका कोई ताल्लुक नहीं
कुछ थोड़ा स्पेसिफिक बता सकते हैं कि कहां करने वाले थे दिल्ली में कोई रिलीजियस प्लेस टारगेट था कोई क्राउडेड एरिया टूरिस्ट प्लेस कोई मतलब जिसे कुछ समझ में आए कि कितना बड़ा इनका काम करने जा रहे थे वो
देखिए जो बातचीत से जो प्रतीत होता है कि निश्चित रूप से कोई ये घटना करना चाह रहे थे
Well, let's go across to our colleagues now. Varnit Gupta joins us, as does Amit and Sagai and Faizan. Very quickly then, starting with you, Varnit, the fact that these are self-radicalized youths and this was a follow-up operation, kind of a preventive raid because the UP ATS had gotten information after they had killed Saifullah in Lucknow the other day. What else are we picking up from our sources?
Well, exactly. Indeed, this is. We can relate this whole operation to Saifullah operation. But as we have heard, ADG Law and Order Daljit Chaudhary is saying that there is no connection of Saifullah encounter with this arresting. But clearly, our top sources in the UP ATS they are telling us that after Saifullah operation they were active and this was a joint operation between the five state police and the Maharashtra ATS was involved in this and Delhi Police Special Cell was also involved in this overall operation and they were trying to they were tracking this overall talks which was happening between the three people who the three accused who
seem to have lost Varnit there. Well, let's go across to Amit. Amit, of course, this was a nationwide sort of exercise, multiple agencies involved as well. And I've been told only Faizan is with us right now, as well as Sagai. So, Faizan, let me come to you right now. There have been youth picked up from Maharashtra as well. These are self-radicalized youth who weren't really in possession of any explosive, but they were planning to carry out terror strikes so as to perhaps somehow impact wherever they were living. What are we picking up about these individuals who've been arrested from Maharashtra per se?
Well, in fact, this is one of the second biggest crackdown by the agencies. You remember that in 2016, the national investigating agencies have busted the biggest module of ISIS who are trying to radicalize the Muslim youth, especially. In this case, what we know so far from the Maharashtra ATS, that there was some specific intelligence input received by this. There are some youths who are in Mumbai trying to build some new organization on the basis of the instructions being given by the handlers in abroad. What the Maharashtra ATS chief have told us, that the youth who was arrested is Nizam Ahmed Shamshad. He is just 26 year old. He was trying to recruit the youths across the Mumbai and Maharashtra. This is the similar case which has been reported in 2016. We remember that. And I have arrested Mudabbir Sheikh, who was a software engineer. He was just 33 year old. He was a recruiter. He was trying to radicalize the Muslim youth and ask them to come and join. What they do exactly, they're trying to put some information on the Facebook. They put some anti-Islamic information on the Facebook, and they see who are the Muslim youths who are liking this, and those who are disagree with those statements. These are the modus operandi on the social media, and this is how they try to get Muslim youths involved in that, and they want them to come and join the ISIS. What we know so far from the Maharashtra ATS is that the Nizam Shamshad Ahmed, 26-year-old, who was arrested yesterday night in a joint operation by the other state police, is that Nizam was a recruiter. He was trying to recruit the youth across the Maharashtra, and other two who aren't yet arrested by the Maharashtra ATS. It is saying that we are trying to interrogate them and trying to find out what exactly so far these guys have done, these suspects have done, because we know that they are very active on the social medias. The gadgets which has been recovered by the Maharashtra ATS from there are some mobile phones, some SIM cards, and some other laptops been recovered from them. ATS is trying to find out what exactly they have done so far, and who are the other youths whom they are in touch, and who are the handlers they are in touch with in abroad.
All right, stay with us, Faizan. Sagai Raj also with us right now. Sagai, a multi-level operation, if you will, a nationwide operation, along with not just the UP ATS, which did take the lead on this, but they did involve other police forces, including the Punjab police, including Andhra police and Bihar police as well. This is just a follow-up, and it does look like there are these modules of self-radicalized individuals who might not really have any relation, but get radicalized and want to join ISIS, clearly a threat to the country and the national security. But it's a big breakthrough as far as Indian agencies are concerned.
Absolutely, sir. In fact, by arresting all these people, they might have cut short on the recruitment as well as the increasing of sleeper cell in South. Absolutely, sir. In fact, by arresting all these people, they might have cut short on the recruitment as well as the increasing of sleeper cell in South India. And when you talk about South India, definitely there are many cases which has come to light earlier, where there are many people who are also trying to leave Kerala and as well as Andhra Pradesh and try to go to the other places, and they want to also join ISIS organizations. So this particular operation is quite crucial, because they are also trying to curtail the increase in the recruitment process as well as increase in sleeper cell. And there is also one incident which has been reported last week, where one Mr. Fiaz Mohammed, who was a main accused in Bengaluru blast, was been picked up from Bangladesh. Probably this particular arrest might have also spilled the bean on the more recruitments as well as the sleeper cell in this particular modus of operandi of the cops by arresting all all these people in North India. Back to you.
All right. Amit also joins us now. Amit Bhardwaj is back with us. Amit, some more details, if you will, as far as this operation is concerned. It seems to be a nationwide operation done in conjunction with various multiple agencies, various police forces, Maharashtra ATS, as well as the UP ATS that took the lead here. It does seem like that the agencies have managed to bust up little modules which could have proven fatal if they had been allowed to let go.
They were working under the Khursana module. There was a module made by them, and they were activating they were very active on the social media also. They have got a website also. And on last 5 months, they were under the surveillance. And after that, the 3 men arrested. But there are many other suspects. And national investigation agencies also written to many states about this kind of activities is going on. So now this module was the Khursana modules. There was a road in which joins northeast to the other part of the Muslim areas. So they were working under that module. And they made many members of their website. And they were very active on the social media also. There were many sleeper cells in North India. They've been written by the national agencies to the Punjab police also, and even Haryana, and even Chandigarh. So they were under the surveillance. The last 5 months, they were under the surveillance. And even the SIB and IB also working on that. They were all continuously giving the information about these modules are active in the North India. And now there are many other suspects as per the police sources and the investigation agency sources, official sources. They said that there are many other arrests is going to be held soon. There are 6 people who are being investigated right now, and another 10 people who are suspect in this whole the process, they're under the surveillance also.
All yes. Right, this is the ISIS Khorasan module. Of course, it takes the name from the erstwhile kingdom of Khorasan, and that's what ISIS uses across the world as well, and online especially. Varnit is back with us now. Varnit, as far as success of an anti-terrorist squad is concerned, this seems to be a major one, because this could lead to more arrests, because it does look like there's a pattern here. The fact that these radicalized youth are self-radicalized, they only need social media to get radicalized and try something. They've been nabbed here. As far as the police is concerned, they believe that these are just misguided individuals, as we heard Daljit Singh say right now, and they will be counseled to get back to the mainstream, but not before more information is gleaned out of them on about who recruits and how do they do it.
Well, exactly, yes. The latest detail which Daljit Chaudhary is sharing with the media, and as per that they are the individual recruiters, and they are not affiliated with ISIS, or they are not affiliated with any terror organization outside India, and they are the self-recruiter, and they are looking for the sympathizers of ISIS in India, and they are very much active on social media, and various SIMs have been found from them, and laptops and the other data has been found from them. And now police is verifying each and everything. They are checking the call details also. They are checking the other details as well. They are checking, even they are looking after their social media page also, on which they are active. So clearly the 5-state police team is looking after this, and they are clearly updating the same to the Ministry of Home also, and they are giving them each and every fact and figure, whatever is required. They are just checking it right now, and clearly, as you said, that
right.
it might help in more
All right,
arresting
but
this
leave it there.